Hi, my name is Suzanne Grande. I am a certified master groomer, and I like to share my passion for grooming with you. I'm here with Bentley, a new client, and he is going to get groomed for the first time with me tonight. So let's see how this goes. You ready, Bentley? We're waiting on the water to warm up. I'm putting him on the groomer's harness to keep him in the tub because he doesn't know me. Gotta wait for the water. Yeah. He's a good boy. Okay. Good boy. You're all right. The harness in the tub is great for keeping dogs from popping up on me because they are anchored down here, which keeps them from popping up. When I originally made this, I called it the anchor pet grooming harness for this reason, but I changed it to groomer's harness because it's not only anchored down, it's used as a regular harness. You calming down? So normally he would have been finished by 8. He did come in for a meet and greet last week, so he's already gotten used to the facility and met me, and that's awesome. Boy, it's okay. It's okay. I'm not gonna hurt you. So let's see if we can reach those animal bands. Come here. Good boy. It's all right. Couldn't find anything. Nope. I'm using Pet Silk Rainforest shampoo and conditioner on him. I love it. Leaves a really nice scent. And it's gentle. I wash every dog myself and my hands are not dried out or cracked or anything. And if I use the wrong shampoo, they're extremely dry after 3 or 4 or 5 dogs. So I can always tell what's gentle. Stuff around his eyes. Good boy. Wait for the water to warm up again. You're fine. You're fine. Good boy.
okay. Not gonna hurt you. No. Not gonna hurt you.
I'm gonna leave this open his mustache until he's done being conditioned, and then I'll rinse that out. Good boy. Good boy. They love this warm conditioner. It feels so good. And it smells good. Doesn't it? Mm, it smells good. Shampoo on your face. Ready? Good boy. You like getting handsome, don't you? Yes, you do. Water. Yeah. Good boy. I like handling new clients live because people can see how they act on their first appointment and how I handle them and get them used to me. Alright. Always want to make sure you rinse them extra long, make sure you get everything off. There's no soap. Good boy. Now we use Vetoconol ear cleansing solution. I fill up each ear with the solution. Rub the ears and let them shake it out.
Good boy.
And here we have the warmed towels, which the doggies love. Yeah. Doggies like the warm towels. Okay, come on. Good boy. All right. There he is. I love about this moving table is if they try to turn away from me, I can just turn them right back. I just don't know what to think about that. And it's small enough that they can't go too far away from me, which is great for my arms because I have trouble with my tension. And that way I don't have to keep bringing them back. Because he's heavy, I've got my hand up under him, supporting his leg, because heavier dogs have weaker joints. This technique is called line brushing. I'm feeding the hair into my hand, creating a line. So again, I'm supporting his weight to protect his knee. Asked me the other day about how much pressure I put on a brush. I use a finger. The finger puts the pressure. My hand balances the brush and the finger puts the pressure. I hold it like this. My thumb balances it, my finger pushes it. If I go this way, my thumb pushes it. I like to use my 5-inch face comb, especially while it's really wet. And I always use the wide side, not the narrow side, because the narrow side will pluck out whiskers. What are we going to do with this? I think I will start with the yellow comb. This is a 5/8 inch. Stay. Stand. Good boy, good stand. There's there, isn't there? Yeah, it's okay for them to find the edge. Makes them stay more still.
You're like, oh crap, there's an itch. I know you hear things out there.
So the other night with one similar to this, I knocked the coat off before the bath because she had a lot more coat with scissors. And then I went back and I scissored her after the bath. This one didn't need very much coat off at all, so the snap-on comb was better for him. And her coat was super, super, super thick, which made scissoring better for her. His is soft. And I'm going to use the orange comb. It's a half inch. It's okay, bud. Good boy. Good dog.
Puppies. I see that wiggly tail.
I see you.
Okay. Up here.
Gonna use a four blade underneath. This'll make him look slimmer.
I got kisses. I think I got kisses.
Good boy.
Good boy.
I'm going to use a five blade under the tail itself because I have a feeling he's going to be one of those that's super sensitive with a breezy bottom. Okay. A breezy bottom is when they do that sit down thing after they've had their back end trimmed. Start off with a seven around his eyes. Since he had a lot of buildup, I'm worried about it being red under there. The Schoenbeo sevens cut almost like an 8.5. Like that was the right call because it's nice and short. Get the same thing on his belly.
Can you come all the way up?
There we go. His pads I'm gonna do with a 15. Since I don't know him, I'm taking extra precautions. When I'm down here. He's got a very hard mat between his toes. It may indicate that he's licking. I'm just gonna shave that out. I'm not gonna comb it out. Let's see. So while I'm on here, I want to talk about a new trend I'm seeing in groomers groups. With people who see a matted dog, they're calling for the groomers to remove the dogs from the owners. Can I just say that that's illegal? If the dog is there being groomed, the owner is seeking help for the dog, and animal control would not take it, so groomers should not take it. So please don't take that advice from these animal rights activists pretending to be groomers, because it's ridiculous. And I'm seeing it all over the place.
Good. Very good. Do you know any tricks?
I bet you do.
I bet you do know tricks.
You look like a dog that would know tricks.
Yes, you do.
All right, let's get rid of this towel. Still don't trust him to stay free. So I'm gonna take a 4 under his chin. Do I want to go all the way?
No, that would freak your people out.
Do a 4 here.
We better not overdo it.
No.
Can I see this one? Good boy. Yes. Good.
See what the back ones look like. Let me see.
Good boy. Good boy. See?
The nice thing about these is if they put their face down there, they're not going to get injured. Another thing is it shoots the dust out this back hole. So you do the nail on the front, then dust shoots downward. Because it's sealed all the way around, it's not going to catch hair. So to protect his knees, I've got him up under here, got the back of his leg braced against me, and this way his knee is protected. My dog is saying, let me out. Stand. Stand. Good boy.
You excited? Are you an excited puppy? It's just too much going on, huh? You are so cute. Yeah.
So on my page today, I uploaded a lot of veterinary webinars for veterinary dermatologists continuing education, which I find to be very interesting. I simply wanted to save those links for myself for later too, so I could find them. The poodles can come out if you want.
Okay. Do you have any more of these treats in
the room? Up on the front counter there's some, and a cookie jar with like a Bichon and an American flag.
That's it.
Yeah.
Ah.
Ammo's already left his. He's working on BBs. I told him he was handsome. He's very cute. Yes, you're very cute.
Okay. Those poodles playing. He says, I want to go play. Yeah. You want to go play with those poodles, don't you? Stand. My husband comes in every day, does all the cleaning, vacuuming, towels, everything to support me. He's been working every day with me. So awesome. So you can see how long-bodied he looks right here. We're going to shorten him up a little. Make him more square. Give him some shape. Stay. Playtime. What's she doing out there, huh? Are they having fun? Oh, they're just having so much fun. Aren't they? Yeah. They're having fun out there. Your time's almost up. We gotta hurry. Hurry. It's almost scissors down time. So when you're getting certified or in grooming competitions, you're given a time limit. And when your time's up, your scissors lay down. So you learn to work in that time. Boy, that. It's okay. I'm sorry, you've got a tangle in your tail. Stay. I know you want to watch the poodles. I'm sorry. See, no fun getting groomed in the poodles are playing, no. I'm sorry. So his ears are a bit layered down. I'm just going to leave those alone because I can't really even them out without taking a lot off. Sometimes less is more. We can't do that with that ear. Gotta do something with that. Because that's just not gonna work, is it? Alright, let's do your feet. Stand. Cool.
I think I get slow this time, Dan.
Yes, I'm running slow.
Of course, my husband brought pizza right before he came, too. So that slowed me down.
Those words, don't you? Yeah, you like those good boy words. You like to hear good boy. You do, you like to hear that. He's a good boy. He's a good, good boy.
The spray is empty. That is eye groom scissoring spray. So now that we're getting to know each other, he can handle slight corrections to get him to stay. The correction's just an or a finger. Mom, if you're watching, you can go ahead and come inside. It's time for scissors down. Yep. Put your tie on backwards. No. Your mommy.
Come on, Dad. Come on. Yeah?
Come on. Your mommy's here. Your mommy's here.
Thanks for watching. We can't wait to see you again next. Click that subscribe button and tap the notification bell so that you don't miss a single video.